Oh, this is for my ladies out there. We're talking about women empowerment. That's why we're here, right? Trusting ourselves, trusting our instincts, really going for it. I never considered myself a designer. Yes, I picked out the materials for the house, and I knew what was pretty. And, you know, for you guys as realtors, I staged the houses. So, you know, staging for yourself is completely different for staging on TV. Now, what I pick out is going to be seen on a national stage. And that's kind of, I mean,
that's scary.
It's scary.
That's scary.
Have y'all seen some of the comments that go on?
Right. Oh, oh man, it's crazy. And luckily, really nobody knows us yet. So that helps, right?
I have a house that I want to share with you guys, which was like my aha moment.
Yeah.
I theme all of my houses. It's just my way of, I don't know, it's like when you have a theme, whether it's for Halloween or Christmas, your Christmas party, I like to dress up. Obviously, I'm drama. I love all the stuff. you know, they wanted to know, Mary, what's going to be the theme for this house? I knew immediately. I had it in my mind. I envisioned it. I went around the neighborhood and I saw there weren't any other houses like the one that I had in my brain. So the crew came to me, John came to me, they're like, okay, Mary, because we had to pitch this to the network. They want to know what our houses are going to look like.
Right.
And I have to be able to sell it. So I was like, this house, I'm hyped, you know, this house is going to be black and white. And they're like,
what?
Yeah.
Right? For all of you realtors that are out there trying
they
to sell
a home. They all cringed.
Home.
It was like, yeah. Mm-hmm. So I was bummed because nobody was on my side. And when I say nobody, nobody.
Not even me.
Including this one right here.
Not even me.
I went to him because I'm like, oh, they don't know. So I'm going to go to John. I'm going to tell him, you know, I laid it all out for him. I'm like, white walls with black crown molding. He goes, look, somebody said, ooh. ooh, ooh. Yeah. Well, I'm just saying. And that's what he said, too. He was like, ooh, you know, my love, like, sorry.
I really
don't think that's a good idea. So now I'm crushed because I'm like, he's supposed to be my friend. You know what I mean? Like, you're supposed to, I support your vision.
Right.
Can we remember that, like, 2 years ago? I support your vision. This is my time. You know, I need support, too. I needed somebody in that moment. Well, guess who that person was? Me.
That one.
When it came down to it, Luis came to me, our painter, and in front of everybody, he was like, oh, okay, I have to go buy the paint tomorrow. What's your colors? And I was like, black and white. It's going to be black and white. So nobody talked to me.
Right.
It was real awkward going forward.
Because,
you know, people, they don't know what's in your mind. They can't see what you see. But again, trusting your instincts, going with your gut. I did it. And guess what? All those people that told me that they didn't think because they never saw it on TV. That was their reason. Because I asked why. Like, why can't I do black and white? Well, it's not really something we've ever seen.
Yeah.
That's the reason? You've never seen a black and white house on HGTV? Oh, that made me even more thrilled. I'm like, oh, we got to do it now. I mean, when does never being able to see something mean not to do it? If anything, it should fuel you to be the first to do it.
Yeah.
And guess what? All those people, including this guy.
Including me.
Yep. They came back to me. What'd you say? What'd you say?
I said, I'm sorry.
And what else you said?
I said,
what else you said?
It was my favorite house. Like it
all
was,
of
it, the house mm-hmm. became, it was beautiful, something that I could never see. And it's a testament to the idea that whenever you do stay true to your instincts,
mm-hmm.
you trust your own vision and you execute it, that you can convince those that don't believe in you
yep.
to actually believe in you.
Well, my takeaway from that was how can we look for other people to empower us when we can't empower ourselves?